Well, this past week was yet another step forward in cloud gaming, and really we have a lot of cool stuff to cover, as really all the services now are on the cusp of upgrading their stuff and moving into the next gen. But then we also have other companies who are still trying to navigate the future of what cloud gaming's even going to look like. With that said, today's news, we're going to take a look at Apple giving the nod for cloud gaming, only with a huge caveat. And folks, it's quite a joke, and not in a good way. xCloud is also on the verge of its launch, and they announced a huge partnership. GeForce now adds more games this week, and Stadia has yet another amazing week with brand new games and a huge consumer-friendly change. So all that's going to be in this video, so make sure you're subscribed for your weekly roundup of cloud gaming news as I make these videos every week, as well as hit that like button so we can find more cloud gamers out there. But alright, let's start this with yet again another Apple controversy with cloud gaming, and really this is starting to become a theme. If you guys aren't aware of what's been going on, to make it quick, Apple has set strict guidelines to the point where no dedicated cloud gaming service could effectively run on their app store, and thus leaving thousands upon thousands of people who would otherwise access services like xCloud, like Stadia or GeForce Now. Not only that, but I even recently covered how Apple is opening up their own cloud gaming service as they filed a patent exactly for that. Whether that though is a factor why these other services are not meant to play nice with Apple is up for another debate. So in the midst of all that, Apple this past week updated their new guidelines for xCloud, Stadia and others to finally possibly join the store, only with one huge kicker. And guys, this is pretty hilarious. I'm not gonna lie, I chuckled at this. Apparently, the new rules show that every game on your service, so for example, Stadia, xCloud, must take every single game and make it downloadable directly from the App Store. So every game must be submitted to Apple individually before a company could stream that to its users. So basically, sure, you can cloud game any of your games on your service, but you have to make it to where you have the option to download it. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I'm pretty sure that defeats the purpose of cloud gaming to begin with, and maybe I'm a bit unclear, but either they want you to download each game, or what I think they want you to do is download an individual app for each and every single game. So in conclusion, Apple does not want to make it to where you have this one app, for example Stadia, where you can launch every game off that one app, but actually make it to where it's individually their own entity and their own software for each and every single title. Thus, then you can actually launch via the cloud. So for example, I have a Stadia account with over 30 to 40 games. If I played 10 of them randomly, I would have to download each and every single game on my iPhone to launch it through the cloud. I mean, at this point, guys, honestly, Apple, I think they're finally trolling us pretty hard here. Now, according to The Verge, Microsoft did reach out with a statement saying this: "This remains a bad experience for customers. Gamers want to jump directly into a game from their curated catalog within one app, just like they do with movies or songs, and not be forced to download over 100 apps to play individual games from the cloud. We're committed to putting gamers at the center of everything we do, and providing a great experience is core to that mission." Now, Google and Nvidia had no comment, but in my opinion, Microsoft nailed it right there. Now, I had made the argument some time ago, and let me know what you guys think, but does Apple have Netflix? Make everyone download an individual app for every single movie or TV show? Or what about music? Does Spotify have to link all their songs to other individual apps with their songs, then you having to load up an app to play that said song? I mean, this is completely ridiculous in my opinion from Apple, and while it is their store, and I know they want their 30% cut, I honestly hope that some form of a true agreement can be worked out, because the only people losing here is us consumers. The fact is, Apple is obviously huge, and the recent mess with the Fortnite that has seen many of its users no longer playing on Apple devices is really a frustrating process overall. With that said, make sure you let me know your thoughts on all of this down below, as I'm curious if you guys agree with Apple and think this is how they should be running their business. Let me know all that down below. I know a lot of you guys will have some thoughts, and I'm curious to see what side you guys are on. But all right, let's finally touch on the rest of the news today, and we have a lot of positive things to go over. Honestly, the cloud gaming battles are really ramping up, and xCloud took a big, huge shot here as they recently announced that they will be teaming up with EA Play to bring their games to the xCloud catalog. Now, EA Play is going to end up having titles like Mass Effect, Battlefield, The Sims, FIFA 21, Titanfall, and some others. It was also confirmed that those with the Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, though, will be able to play some of these EA titles on Android devices at no additional charge. Now, this obviously is huge. Excellent news, and honestly, it makes xCloud a contender if you're looking to cloud game and you're looking for the biggest catalog of games at one spot. I still have my reservations on the service, but it's honestly really hard to deny with xCloud looking to have over 100 titles at launch ready to go that you might want to use this as your full cloud gaming service, or at the very minimum supplement your cloud gaming needs with just a monthly subscription. We'll see how this all goes. I will be covering xCloud on launch on the 15th, so check the channel for that video and make sure that you're subscribed. All right, Stadia this past week was completely quiet up until the very end as they were waiting for that Ubisoft event, and man, Stadia came out guns a-blazing with the new announcement of an exclusive demo for Immortals Fenyx Rising that no other platform is getting. But that was not the biggest announcement in my opinion, but the fact that this demo will be playable for anyone with just a Gmail account. So if you've wanted to play Stadia, but have not wanted to sign up for Stadia Pro, even though you do get your first month free, now you'll be able to play this exclusive demo that features a created island that only Stadia is receiving. So no Xbox, no PlayStation, nobody. This is exclusive gameplay, followed by anyone able to play this demo with just your email. This was something that I had wanted for a long time. The ability to play Stadia completely free, devoid of any inserting of form of payments, even just for a trial, and just to launch a game and see if Stadia just works for you. I will have an announcement on one of these videos when this demo does go live, so if you're wondering about Stadia and if it runs and plays and it's good for you, this demo will be something to watch out for. Now, Stadia was not done there though, as they announced two more games in Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, The Complete Edition, a beat-em-up with great pixel graphics, and a new MMO in Riders Republic that will feature lots of players in the same world, featuring races with and against each other, and the game is set to come out February 25th, 2021. So all in all, while no games released this past week, it was a great week in terms of the outlook for Stadia, having more games on the way, and now a free playable demo for all. Well, GeForce Now had another excellent week this week, releasing up to 10 new games for the service, as well as two games for free that you can play on GFN, as well as the new feature for GeForce Now that is Ansel, that lets you take professional-grade photographs of your game. If you're interested in Ansel, you can simply use the GeForce Now in-game overlay to professionally touch up your screenshots and launch this new feature. But like always, every week there is two games that you guys can claim with Epic Games and play both of those titles on GeForce Now. And the two games this week are Railway Empires and Where the Water Tastes Like Wine. Both of these are solid games with good reviews and are completely free. Claim those games and play them on GeForce Now with the free tier or your founder's plan. With that, we also have games that are new to the service that came this past week with Star Renegades, Dungeon of the Endless, Pro Cycling Manager 2019, Skullgirls, U-Boat, Assassin's Creed Chronicles China with Uplay, as well as returning to the service we have Endless Space 2. The last thing that I actually want to touch on, as this was a stealth drop, is Marvel Avengers is now on GeForce Now as well. Now, I've gotten to play this game and it is a ton of fun, and it's worthy of the hype that it's gotten, so go ahead and check that out, and I was extremely happy to see GeForce Now get such a huge game. But alright, with all this news this past week, be sure to tell me your guys' thoughts. What do you guys think about Apple? Do you think it's fair? Are you guys on the side of Apple, maybe? Or do you guys possibly think that this is all a bunch of nonsense? Or are you somewhere in between? Also, let me know your thoughts on the news with xCloud, Stadia, or GeForce Now, as a lot has definitely happened with all these services this past week. Also, do me a favor if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel for your weekly roundup of cloud gaming news, and smash that like button. I'm Sunny, and I'll see you guys in the cloud.